too long. Welcome to today's show. I'm Woody Wood. Today we're on Lake Jackson, fishing for crappie. Yesterday, I had an amazing day out here. I caught 33 slab crappie, caught a couple stripers, caught about 4 spotted bass. Everything right up here in front of me, I'm baiting up with minnows, and I've got some fiberglass poles, and I've got a couple rods that I'm going to be tight lining. So we're going to try our luck. I got my wife with me today, so that's always a little extra luck. So stay tuned, and we'll be right back. Got here a pretty good little pole here. It's like a nice crappie. Wow, folks, look at that. That's what the day I hope is going to bring, about 30 more of these. That's a nice fish. We should be getting right up on top of this structure here pretty soon. So let me bait this one back up and get it back out. What we got here is October, late October, and of course the water temperature is cooling off down to about 70 degrees. The fish are going into like a fall pattern, the same thing they do in a spring pattern. What they're doing is they're feeding, they're fattening up for the winter, and they're going to feed from now to probably around the end of November, and then they'll just go into deep holes and they'll just sit there till spring. So that's pretty much what we got here. We got a fall pattern of crappie, bass, stripers, and the whole bit. So hang on, let's see what else we do. I'm going to bait this one up. All right, let me tell you about what we did. We started out and had an approach with the wind blowing toward the fish, or where the fish were. As you see, we've already caught two. A little technique that I use. I let this rod be a little deeper, and I let it get hung up. This rod is hung up on this treetop or branches and brush pile and where the fish are located. Now I've had time to put out all my poles, get set up. So in the wind blowing a little bit today, I decided to bring out a buoy marker. That way I'll know where the fish are and I can troll and stay as close as I can around where the fish are and brush pile as well. So I'm going to toss this in, and after that I'm going to get this rod untangled, get up there in the front with the trolling motor, and go to work. That ought to mark it right there. Loose, save my hook, ready to bait back up and go to business. There you go. Let me know when you want to go fishing, all right? That's good.
All right.
Got this one down deep, right on top of the treetop, right on the outside of the treetops here. About 26 foot of water. This fish was right around about 20. So, there we go. Back on top of the orange buoy over here, and we're catching fish again. Alright, so, gotta stay on top of it here. I don't want to get hung back up. See if I can back out just a little bit. I'm seeing structure on the graph, so as I move this trolling motor, I got another fish. Yeah, I was about to say, when you start moving that minnow around, these fish are going to come out and they're going to eat. It's kind of like it it attracts them, just like an aggressive mode, a feeding mode. These fish will start seeing that bait. There's another one. Seeing that bait move.
Where?
And it gets their attention.
There he is.
Hold on, let him hook again. See there?
Missed it. My
get
fault.
It? He'll come back and get it, though. It's probably a spotted bass. With the crappie, will end up just a tail in it.
Yeah, well.
How about this? On my knees, diving for the pole. What I'm talking about, they're all around this tree. It's hard to fish by yourself when you're catching this many fish at one time. Don't get no better than this, I promise you. I'll tell you what, I'm going to see if we can drift on out of here, come back again, and attack this spot with get some more fish. So give me time to get baited up and get back on the fish. Be right back.
Oh, really?
Check that out. Check. Must be a little striper or something. Or a big crappie. That's a big crappie right there.
Goodness gracious.
Check that out, y'all. Look at the size of that one. Yep. That baby's going home there. Wow, what a fish. What a fish. That fish will go close to 2 pounds. How do you like that? That's real crappie. We're right here on top of this brush pile. We got another one going right here on the pole right here. Hang on. Before he pulls it off.
Woody knows how to hold his mouth right.
There you go. It's all you want, folks. What we'll do, we'll try to get baited back up again and get right back on top of them as soon as they quit biting. I wouldn't mind to have about 12 more of those. All right, that's pretty. That one's going home there. Oh, we had one pick it up down there at about 20 foot. Looks like a largemouth. There you go. Good 2 pound fish. Yeah, everything I'm catching right now seems to be down deep. I've got the poles running in around 10 to 12 deep, and I got these rods at about 15 to 20. And I'm fishing in about 26 foot of water. I saw a big gar a while ago come in here, so that's not good. They like to scare the fish away. So, bait back up, try it again, going after them. We've caught two big crappie, a while ago. And we didn't get that on camera though. Okay, so we'll be right back.
We have caught a mess of fish. Enough for the beginnings of a good fish fry.
That's real damn good.
Folks, I'll tell you something. Look at that right there. I want to thank my wife for going with me today. I had a wonderful time fishing on Lake Jackson for crappie. And you know what? If you look at that right there, that's something to be proud of. You got one there weighing a little over 2 pounds. You got the rest of them around pound and a half, pound and three quarters. So I'm going to tell you something, folks. Right now, they in a fall pattern. Get you some minnows, some jigs, get on some deep brush piles. Should do pretty good. Crappie as far as bass, stripers, and everything else. So, hope you enjoyed the coverage today. And listen, look forward to seeing you next time on the Woody Wood Fishing Show.